Now I'm going to have Ken read you just the 7 points of the original Akron program.
One of the things I mentioned earlier was that we're very much focused on reporting. That is not making stuff up, but sharing with you things that you can verify for yourself, especially from AA General Service Conference approved literature, so that you can see this is really part of what happened. And what I'm about to read to you comes from Dr. Bob and the Good Old Timers on page 131. It says, quote, in meeting with a number of men, their wives, and, quote, in some cases, their mothers, end of quote, Mr. Amos heard varying stories, quote, many of them almost miraculous, end of quote. He notes, however, when it came to recovery, they were all remarkably alike in, quote, the technique and the system followed, end of quote. He described the, quote, program, end of quote, as follows, quote, one, an alcoholic must realize that he is an alcoholic, incurable from a medical viewpoint, and that he must never again drink anything with alcohol in it. Two, he must surrender himself absolutely to God, realizing that in himself there is no hope. Three, not only must he want to stop drinking permanently, he must remove from his life other sins, such as hatred, adultery, and others which frequently accompany alcoholism. Unless he will do this absolutely, Smith and his associates refuse to work with him. Four, he must have devotions every morning, a, quote, quiet time, end of quote, of prayer, and some reading from the Bible and other religious literature. Unless this is faithfully followed, there is grave danger of backsliding. Five, he must be willing to help other alcoholics get straightened out. This throws up a protective barrier and strengthens his own willpower and convictions. Six, it is important, but not vital, that he meet frequently with other reformed alcoholics and form both a social and a religious comradeship. Seven, important, but not vital, that he attend some religious service at least once weekly, end of quote.